My name is Nikko Leber, and welcome to the Santa Barbara Mission.
Mission Santa Barbara was founded on December 4th, 1786. It is called Queen of the Missions for its grace and beauty. Father Junipero Serra planned on starting this mission, but died 2 years earlier.
Furman Las Wayne was the founder of Santa Barbara Mission in 1786.
Padre Antonio Paterna, a companion of Sierra, put up the first buildings and made the first converts. The goal of Mission Santa Barbara was to convert the Chumash Indians into Christianity. The Chumash Indians inhabited the area from Malibu to San Luis Obispo. Many Chumash leaders were converted to Christianity. Descendants of the Chumash live in Santa Barbara today. The Chumash Indians learned about farming and learned how to make adobes, tiles, shoes, woolen garments. They learned about carpentry, masonry, became herdsmen, and farmers. They also learned how to sing and play European music. Church services even have a choir consisting of Indians. They use instruments such as violin, cellos, woodwind, and brasses. When we went to Santa Barbara Mission, we saw a lot of cool things there.
Welcome to the sacred garden.
The garden was a work area where the Indians learned how to trade. Many of the native plants used by the Chumash Indian people are displayed here on the mission grounds.
This is the ox cart. This is what they use right here. This is what they used for bringing stuff from the beach to the mission. And you can see right here, that's where they put the horses.
The oxes, I mean.
Oxes. That's why they called it the ox cart.
Here are examples of tools and building materials. Here are some large Indian-made sculptures. The inside of the church is awesome. On the floor are two stone plaques. These plaques are of missionaries and laymen buried in the crypt below the floor.
Welcome to the Santa Barbara Mission Cemetery.
If you look above this door, you'll see a skull and crossbones. This tells you now you're entering a cemetery. The cemetery was started in 1789. There are 4,000 Indians buried here. One of these Indians you might be familiar with. If you read Island of the Blue Dolphins, then you're familiar with Juana Maria. She was the lone woman of the St. Nicholas Islands. She was buried here on 1853. Here's a memorial to her burial.
In 1808, Native American used this fountain. This is a washing base. This is where the Indians wash their clothes. And that big tank is filled with water.
This was also called the Lavanderia.
This is a typical display of the mission kitchen.
This is an example of furnishings in a missionary's bedroom. Spain had lost California to Mexico in 1822, and in 1834, the mission was secularized. In 1843, the mission was returned to the Franciscans. Soon after, the governor confiscated the lands, and in 1846, the mission was sold. Even though most missions in California were abandoned or turned into barns, in 1865, the mission was returned to the Catholic Church by Abraham Lincoln. The mission has gone through several restorations. One major restoration has taken place after the 1925 earthquake. The earthquake was a 6.8 on the Richter scale. It caused a lot of damage. The front of the church had to be completely rebuilt.